Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Okay, in the video so far we've covered quite a lot of the basics. We've talked about weapons and equipment and stuff like that. And so in the following few videos, I figured I'd show you a little bit about leveling up, about getting to the second level of the dungeon. And hopefully we'll be able to fight one of the boss monsters pretty soon. So like I said in the last video, what I did is I played a little bit off screen. I've upped my fighter experience a bit by cleaning out this tower. I also finished off this tower. Basically just killed everything inside and took all the equipment. And I'm now up to 5500 experience on my fighter side, and on the wizard side I'm up to 800. I was talking about this earlier. The wizard experience will be a little bit slow on the first level because, well, basically you'll be using your sword or more than your magic, or at least I do. I've killed most of the creatures outside, but as you can see there's still a couple left. And we'll be getting rid of those as well. Now there's a few things you have to keep in mind when leveling up in this game, and that is that of course, if you level up, you get more hit points, you get stronger attacks, a bunch of access to higher levels, that sort of thing. But there's also a downside, and the downside is that stuff becomes more expensive. So on the higher levels, you start eating more food more quickly, so you'll want to stock up on food more. And also another important part is that the key shop becomes a lot more expensive. So keys right now, I'll show you quickly in the shopping area down here. You can buy keys here. Keys right now cost us 75 gold pieces a piece. So that's pretty cheap. Every time you level up, that doubles. So if I went to upgrade my fighter level right now and came back to the key shop, it would be 150 instead of 75. And if you level again, it'll be 300 and so on and so on. So really what you want to do is try and get as much gold as possible before you level up, and then buy a whole bunch of keys all at once, because keys are going to get really expensive later on, and they're also very, very important. In the first level you don't use them so much yet, in some of the towers maybe, but from level 2 and 3 onwards there are places where you just need more keys just to be able to get further in the game. So yeah, keys are very expensive. As you can see, I've saved about 3400 gold right now, so I'm going to use a lot of that to buy keys. I'm thinking about maybe 20 or so. I do want to save a little bit of gold because I want to be able to heal once I level up, just so I can get to my max hit points. I think if we save about 400-300 gold, that should be plenty. And we have 41 keys now, so that should last us a good long while. It does mean I won't be able to upgrade my weapon or my magic, but we don't really need that quite yet. And once we get to level 2, we'll be able to get a lot more money very quickly. So that's not such a big deal. And the money we save on keys now is going to make a lot of difference in the future. Okay, so with that said, it's time to get our level up. Now, you can level up in two different ways. You can either go back to the starting town, which is a little bit tricky, or you can just find a temple. And the temple will, the priest at the temple will give you your new rank and everything else. So in this case, I think I'll just go to the temple because, yeah, that'll be fine. Kill these guys. The temple in level 1, some levels have a bunch of temples, but the temple for level 1 is all the way at the top. And just find a ladder that goes all the way up. Kill some more stuff along the way. Just take the ladder up, get these guys out of the way. Here we go, this is the place. See, the temple is right there. Oh, I really didn't want to do that. Ah, thank god, there's a bowlask. I was talking about this before, these anvils can be really dangerous because they can really get you stuck if you don't have any monsters to fight to get you out. Thankfully, we had a bowlask right there, which helped us out. So to get this temple, you just have to jump this little gap. It's a little bit tricky at first, you have to time it right, but it's not that hard. Okay, and then As soon as you get into the temple, just by pressing the space bar like everywhere else, the priest will give you a new level if you have enough experience. So, go in, and we are now fighter level 2, and the title we get is Aspirant. We're almost at 6,000 experience. Is that enough to get another level? I'm not sure. Can't hurt to check real quick. So we have 6,000 experience. Let's see if that's enough to get to level 3 right away. That might actually be useful. Oh yeah, before I start, I should probably talk about the stuff you get for leveling up. So pulling up the statistics page real quick. As you can see, we used to have 1500 hit points maximum. We're now at 4000, so that's more than doubled. We have also increased our strength by 5 points, our dexterity by 5 points, and our agility by 5 points, and that's because we upgraded the fighter level. If we had upgraded our mage level instead, we'd have gotten 5 extra experience, intelligence, wisdom, and magic resistance. As I said before, magic resistance is not really important right now, but it will become much more important in the later levels. Let's see. Okay, yeah, 6,000 is not enough to level up again. We're gonna have to kill a bunch more critters to do that, but we'll do that in level 2. So, okay, we leveled up now. I'll just give you a quick look at what I was talking about earlier, the way items become more expensive. So if I go into the guild shop now, as you can see, our keys now cost 150 gold pieces each instead of 75, so that's a lot more for just one level. And food, if you look at my food count right now, it's 584, and as you see, it just dropped down to 580. And if we wait a little bit more, it'll drop down to 576. So right now we're eating 4 food for every tick, and before we were only eating 2, so that's also doubled. And it will keep doubling for every level you gain. So it might be a good idea to stock up on some extra food right now. Let's take, I don't know, 200 gold worth. That'll keep us fed for a while. And we'll go exit again. So yeah, we don't have any money to upgrade any of our other stuff, but like I said, it's not the most important thing in the world right now. Let me just show you a little bit of how to get to level 2. So, okay, we've got our level now. You need to be at least level 2 in order to get proceed to the next level of the dungeon. Since we've done that now, I can show you the actual exit is right here in the bottom right. And before we go in there, let me just go to the healer, and which, as you can see, has also become a lot more expensive. It was, I think, 80 gold pieces before, and now it's 240 because we've got a lot more hit points to heal. I'll take it in this case, so we're up to 4,000. Okay, so this is the cave entrance to level 2. And just enter it the same as any other place, just by pressing the spacebar. I'll just show you one or two monster fights out here, just to give you a little bit of a feel for level 2. In level 2 you start in this little area that's has no exit except for the locked doors on the right there. Both of these doors lead to the same area, so you don't have to open them both. So don't waste your keys, just get one or the other, and I usually take this one because it's closer to the exit. But don't open them both, because it's just a wasted key. Same for this area, to the left here. If I remember, there's nothing really important back there, so just you can just leave this one closed as well. Let's see if I can find any creatures to fight. Wait, I saw something down there, I think. Yeah, let's get this hood. Oh, he's only one little guy. Poor guy. Yep, and he just gave us some food. 60 food instead of the 10 we were getting from the Boalisks earlier. That's because everything in level 2 you get a lot more of. Whether it's food or gold, these creatures drop a lot more than we're used to from level 1. The experience is also a lot better, as you can just... as you saw coming by just there, these hoods give you 40 experience, whereas most level 1 creatures just give you 10. So getting our magic level up to date is going to be really easy here, just because there's a lot more experience to be had from fighting most of these guys. Let's get this Garbug as well. On the other hand, you can see that the monsters also have a lot more health than they did on level 1. These guys have 600, oh, damn it. I hate killing these because they give me a lot of gold. Or killing these boxes, I meant. I don't know if I mentioned this before, but your magic can actually blow up your treasure boxes, so be very careful when you're using magic. Get these out of the way. There we go. We're straight back up to 700 gold now, so yeah, these guys, they're definitely a lot more valuable than the level 1 guys. Ruby, I think that increases my strength for a little while. Oh, there's one more thing I should probably mention about level 2, which is kind of tricky if you're not used to it. Level 2 is the first level that uses a bunch of teleports all over the place. So you might have noticed I was walking up here the whole time, instead of down by the little corridor below me. And that's because the little corridor teleports you back and forth. As you can see, if I walk back and forth here, it just takes me to different areas all the time. So yeah, that's just something you have to get used to a little bit. Just try it a couple of times, it's actually pretty simple in this level still. In following levels it's going to be a lot more difficult. There's, I think, levels 6 or 7 or so, they become really crazy. Again, 70 gold for each of these guys, so yeah, you get a lot of gold really quickly. We just killed like 3 creatures in level 2 and I'm already up to 1200 gold or so. And these aren't even the best ones, there's a couple that are even better. So yeah, that's just a quick primer on how to level up and how to get to level 2. I think we're coming up on our time, so I'll cut off the video here. In the next part, I think I'll get a bit more golden experience off screen so we can upgrade our equipment and hopefully level up one or two more levels. We can see if we can take a stab at the boss guy for level 1. Okay, thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you in the next part.